At every beginning, there is a spark. A flame that starts the fire. In 1978, that spark started with a church planter and pastor named Dick Landis when he established a church in Stratford, New Jersey, and called it Word Fellowship Church. Since that day, the church underwent multiple physical transformations, seasons of growth, as well as leadership transitions in its early years. In 2002, Marcus Eric, a pastor and a son of a missionary, along with his wife Susan and two kids, Michael and Jessica, follow God's call from across the world to become the senior leader of Word Fellowship Church. He came with a calling on his life and a prophetic vision for the destiny of this church: to restore the brokenhearted and setting the captives free, to light a flame of revival in New Jersey and see it carry out into the world. Now, 40 years later, a time of recent trials and testing is about to come to a close. The time of breakthrough is upon us. As with other moves of God, these shifts are often predicated by an affirmation of identity. At the beginning of this year, God spoke clearly into our identity and spoke into us a new name: Word Life Center. With this new name, God is signifying the birth of something new in us, preparing us for the outpouring of His Spirit in a bold and fresh way. For many of us, these past couple years have been our character molding in the wilderness, where all we have left is our unconditional yes. It's in that place of surrender that we are now able to receive the outpouring of His Spirit and begin to carry the weight of the calling on our lives. And we are not alone. God's Spirit has been pouring out over the nations in a new way. There is a hunger and courageous abandonment that has been stirring in the global body of Christ like never before. People are no longer satisfied with the status quo. They are giving more generously than they have before. The gospel is being shared in the darkest and furthest places and to people that once seemed unreachable. Strongholds of the enemy are being taken back. Healings of the body, mind, and soul are happening in unprecedented and miraculous ways. The testimony of God's goodness and love is moving across the earth with unstoppable force. Dreams, visions, and revelations are being awakened in every soul across the world. And we are no exception. Our purpose is being affirmed, our identity sealed, and our mission clear. Our mission is to love God with all of our heart, to love our neighbor as ourselves, equip the saints to seek, save, and disciple the lost through God's patience and kindness that leads people to repentance. Our name, Word Life Center, it means in the beginning was the Word, and we owe people an encounter with the Word, who is a person, Jesus Christ incarnate. He brings us into fullness of life, life abundantly, a life of identity and destiny, life in relationship with the Father, planned before the foundation of time. The center is a place where we live out the culture on earth as it is in heaven. We train, teach, and disciple, live a life of love where signs and wonders follow us, where nothing is impossible, and dreams are so big that only God can make them reality. Our passion is to seek His presence. Our passion is to see revival. But what does revival look like? It looks like our city becoming all it was created to be, families restored and made whole, individuals confident in their identity and relationship with their Heavenly Father, businesses flourishing, government working out of peace and not strife, and having creative solutions to problems, education systems releasing the next generation of kingdom builders, denominational lines broken between churches, and a nation and its people turning back to God as their first love and being fully redeemed into their divine destiny and purpose. But revival starts with us. We cannot give to others what we haven't experienced ourselves. When we realize who we are in Christ, becoming fully alive, that is when we bring unstoppable hope and revival to our family, city, and our world. And we walk in this promise. God has promised that we will see revival in this land. You are called out from among them.
You will receive a new name.
You were called ugly, but now I have called you my adornment.
You were fear, but I have called you unstoppable courage.
You were bitter, and I have called you irresistible kindness.
You were tired, and I called you mighty conqueror.
You were abandoned, and I called you my treasure, for I have pursued you.
The song, You Won't Relent. Sing the chorus as if God is asking us to be that fire inside of Him. Be the flame upon His heart.
Your love matters to God so much, in fact, that until He has it, you will not have peace.
The Bible speaks of the river of God, and it is coming. A huge, mighty river is coming over the dry, parched land.
There are those who will stay on the riverbanks and be splashed by its overflow, but never experience its powerful, consuming force.
But let us not fear the unknown for us, for it is God's river, and it is wonderful.
He is not a God who gets satisfaction over our list of good deeds.
But He craves our love and our affection.
Like a lover, He craves our affections and our extravagant love, our spontaneous laughter, and our moments of peaceful pondering.
He wants every moment to be felt with Him.
The chaos of battling with truth and lies must be taken to the cross and abandoned. You cannot swim with these burdens of guilt and shame.
What does this all-consuming river demand?
It will demand everything. Our money, our time, our old ways of being churched.
Our feeling in control of our lives and knowing what is going to happen next.
For those who jump in the river,
there will be men so dead and hardened, but your touch on his shoulder will melt years of rage and stubbornness.
A girl so determined to numb herself from God's love, but your hug will shake her to the core.
A family so shredded by the spikes of words of meanness and belittling, but your prophetic words will reveal heart conditions and heal those emotions of hopeless insecurity.
A woman so abandoned and afraid and desperate that just your eye contact and your unconditional love will draw her to trust in me.
That every word you say would have a purpose in the kingdom of God.
Every prayer would shoot down demons.
Every gathering of believers would be terror to the enemy and a triumphal victory for heaven.
Every tear would be shed for others and not for ourselves.
Every unlovable soul will feel like a prince and princess.
Every song we sing will join in with the songs of heaven and the multitude of angels.
No one could deny that there is a new move of God upon the earth in Stratford, New Jersey.
So what are we doing with this promise? Now, more than ever, we are bringing heaven to earth, giving people an encounter with their loving Heavenly Father, binding up the brokenhearted, setting the captives free, raiding the gates of hell for heaven, living with an unoffended heart, living out God's patience and kindness. We are boldly declaring dreams, visions, and revival awakenings, increase in favor in physical, mental, and soul health, increase in finances and promotions, death to debt in families, cities, and nations, 1,000 times return in saved souls, neighborhoods healed, families restored, and nations turning to Jesus. Eyes opened, hearts set free, and belief systems reconciled to God, that God is in a good mood, a good Father, and we are His beloved children, that His plans for us are always good, and His thoughts towards us are always full of love. We are first worshipers. We will not be shaken. We are strong, courageous, and bold. We are free from fear. And that we are purposely designed and strategically placed right where we are to impact the kingdom of God. The time has come. The season is now. The rising of the dawn is here, and a new day has begun. A chapter has been written and another begins. A people once in hiding are being released on the earth. The tidal wave of revival is getting stronger, and we are getting ready. We have waited, we have cried, we have laughed, we have struggled, but in the end, those who persevere are being released into their destiny. The trials are fierce, the battles are real, the stories are raw, but the victory is sweet. He has made us conquerors, We are his sons. We are his daughters. The time is now for us to rise into the fullness of our destinies. Our hunger for the more of God has wrecked us for the status quo. The kingdom of heaven is invading earth. The torch of revival has been lit. The light is getting brighter, and the time is now for us to fan the flame. He has given us life, so let's bring life.